But now it's time to discover the Max Verstappens, the Valentino Rosses, and the Steve Jobs of the freight world. The time is now with main part of today's event. Thank you. Here we go. The presentation of the 11 Sponsors Trophy for the BIFA Freight Service Awards 2023. And in true Oscar style, the sponsor of each category will now join me on stage to announce the trophy winner. And if I could just have a little hush for 1 second. The representative of the winning company is invited to collect their trophy from me. So please do, when your name is called out, make your way to the stage as fast as you can, please. It doesn't have to be Formula One fast, but if you can get kind of touring cars, we'll be getting through this. We'll start our trophy awarding today by announcing winners in the general categories of the competition, please. And the first category in this group is the Project Forwarding Award. And I'd like to call upon Daniel Wright from sponsor Macbeth Insurance Brokers to join me on stage to announce the winner of this year's award, please.
Great to see you, Daniel. The successful handling of major project shipment requires much planning and a multidisciplinary team. In this category, sponsored by Macbeth Insurance Brokers, BIFA invited case studies from members that have completed an out-of-gauge project or coordinated a complex movement that has reached a conclusion in the past 12 months. So please feel free to cheer for every finalist this afternoon. The four finalists for the Project Forwarding Award are Brunel Shipping and Liner Services, Hemisphere Freight Services, Peters and May, and UCargo. Daniel.
And the winner is Hemisphere Freight.
Our first winner this afternoon, Hemisphere Freight, showed ongoing dedication and commitment during a project spanning 3 years on behalf of the National Grid for their flagship Hinkley Connection project. They provided UK side logistics encompassing the discharge of charter vessels, shortage and storage, and transport of 160 newly designed T-pylons for installation at sites in the north and west of England to supply homegrown low-carbon energy. What may have initially looked straightforward definitely wasn't. Now, the members of the judging panel would also like to recognize UCargo with a highly commended trophy this year. Would the representative from UCargo please make your way to the stage as quickly as possible? Now, I can tell you, UCargo are specialists in moving large-scale entertainment equipment for events around the world, which they've demonstrated as previous winners of the Project Forwarding Award. And this new project then undertakes the largest move yet. 125 pieces of cargo in trailers, containers, and breakbulk from diverse origins, including shipments from the USA, the Philippines, Spain, and Saudi Arabia, as well as from the UK and Europe to Kuwait. This project included charter movement, which required meticulous loading plans for lifting the unusual and varied sized pieces and proactive response to last minute challenges. UCargo have once again demonstrated their prowess and experience in this unique sector of project forwarding. Congratulations.
Gosh, never ask us to ever organise musical chairs for you, but we'll get there in the end. Okay, now on to the second award today, the Specialist Services Award. And I'd like to invite Steve Breen from sponsor Time IT to come to the stage to announce the winner of this year's award, please. Here he is already.
Thanks for joining us, Steve. The services offered by a modern freight forwarder extend far beyond the provision of basic transportation and documentation. This category is for value-added services that enhance the customer experience, enabling them to concentrate on their core business. Such services need not be modal-specific and could include warehousing, pick and pack, technology service, air or shipping line agency, or express services. We love your cheering, by the way. The four finalists for the Specialist Services Award are Cardinal Global Logistics, Metro Shipping, Seafast Logistics, and U-Cargo. Steve.
And the winner of the category is Seafast Logistics.
Seafast Limited emerged as the clear victor in the Specialist Services category of the BIFA Freight Service Awards 2023 due to their commitment to supporting the supply chain of humanitarian aid organizations in post-conflict regions. Their impressive achievements in reducing transit times and delivering substantial cost savings, Seafast's dedication to delivering specialized services with a customer-centric approach set them apart, making them the deserving winner in the highly competitive Specialist Services category. Congratulations.
All the way from the back, pretty sure he didn't think he was going. Can you hear at the back? You're right at the back. Excellent. Right, now on to Staff Development Award. And I'd like to ask Cliff Atkinson from sponsor Albacore Systems to join me on stage to announce the winner of this year's trophy, please.
Good to see you, Cliff. You've got a fan base. BIFA members, whatever their size, need comprehensive training programs to keep abreast of regular changes in regulations, industry practices, and general business matters. In this category, the judges want to understand how you encourage and develop all personnel to be their best and contribute to the success and direction of your business. And so, the finalists for the Staff Development Award are DHL Global Forwarding, Cranley Logistics, OIA Global, Uniserve Group, and Unsworth. Cliff.
And the winner is OIA Global.
While they're strategically positioned near the front, the judges were impressed with OIA's commitment to staff development and the investment in their employees. OIA's continuous improvement team, performance and learning objectives, Employees Appreciation Week, Most Valuable Teammate Award, and of course their commitment to mental health were all particular features of the presentation. Congratulations, OIA Global.
Well done, and I think the loudest table in the room as well, so well done for the vocals. So the final award then in the general category is the Supply Chain Management Award, and I ask Shane Paddington of sponsor Boxtop Technologies to come here on stage to announce the winner of this year's trophy. Come on, Shane.
Thanks for joining us this afternoon, Shane. Now, have you worked with a customer to analyze their existing procurement procedures and provided a customer-focused, innovative solution enabling a more efficient and cost-effective management of that supply chain? Now, if the answer is yes, then this is the category for you. The finalists for the Supply Chain Management Award are Atlantic Global Logistics, Kerry Logistics. Legentia UK. Nuatum Logistics. And Uniserve Group. Shane's got the winner.
And the winner is Kerry Logistics.
It's a logistical nightmare coming from table 34, I can tell you that. Brilliant though, Kerry Logistics showed outstanding management to successfully transform its customers' supply chain model
by setting up
a consolidation hub in Ningbo. This produced a 50% improvement on lead time, and Kerry Logistics helped reduce costs by 35%. At the heart of the success of the Ningbo hub is Kerry's bespoke digital solution, and that's called Carrier Vision. This creates visibility all over all stock and also empowers customers to streamline operations, gain real-time insights, and enhance decision-making capabilities.
Some logistics navigating through all the tables there. Well done. Moving on now then to celebrate those inspiring individuals in the Apprentice of the Year and Young Freight Forwarder of the Year award. So first I invite Sophie Side of Sponsor Menzies LLP to join me on stage to announce the winner of the Apprentice of the Year award.
It's a lovely award to give out. Thanks for joining us, Sophie. BIFA encourages members to employ apprentices to ensure the industry is well positioned to meet future requirements. In this category, BIFA members are invited to nominate outstanding individuals to showcase the difference the named apprentice has made to their organization. The six finalists for Apprentice of the Year Award are Cameron Smith of Legentia UK. Jacob Swift of FSM Clearance. Kieran Elkin of DAXA. Leanne Reed of Neon Freight. Richard Smith of Ziegler UK. And Samuel Barrett of Charles Kendall Freight. Over to you, Sophie.
And the winner is Cameron Smith.
Well, the six finalists in the competition were absolutely impressive, and their passion for the industry was evident. After careful consideration, Cameron Smith was selected as the winner due to his exceptional knowledge and commercial awareness of the industry. His ability to build strong relationships with clients and colleagues was impressive. His dedication has earned him a place in a global development program, which will see him traveling to many different countries. And of course, with such a strong field of contenders, the judging panel would also like to recognize Jacob Swift of Everset Clearance with a highly commended award. Jacob, please make your way to the stage as soon as you can to collect your well-earned trophy. In his own words, Jacob fell in love with the industry and customs in particular. He was highly commended for his attention to detail, his pragmatic solutions, and professionalism. Despite being relatively new to the industry, Jacob has taken on a leadership role in training younger members of his company and demonstrating a strong team ethic. Here he comes. Congratulations, Jacob Swift.
Tell you what, got some swagger, Jacob, just taking his time, cool as a cucumber down the side of the room. Well done, Jacob, and congratulations, Cameron, as well. It was Cameron that I was actually talking to earlier about the industry, so fantastic to see that success there. Now, the second category for individuals is the Young Freight Forwarder of the Year, and The winner announced today will be nominated to represent BIFA and the UK forwarding industry at the FIATA International Logistics Professional Competition this year. Please, could I ask Sam Campion of Virgin Atlantic Cargo to come and join me on stage to announce the winner of the Young Freight Forwarder of the Year trophy. Come on, Sam.
Thanks, Sam. The Young Freight Forwarder Award was established to recognise an individual with the drive and ambition to flourish in the international freight industry. Entrants must be under the age of 32, employed by a BIFA member, and have a minimum of 2 years' experience across relevant disciplines. The winner of the prestigious Young Freight Forwarder Award will be nominated by BIFA to represent the UK in the FIATA TT Club Young Logistics Professional Award competition next year. Here we go then. The six finalists for the Young Freight Forwarder of the Year Award are Amelia Mulhern of Kuehne+Nagel, Christopher Carter of Peterson, UK, Emily Howard of Westbound Logistics, Georgia Gibson of Cargo Partner, Michael Shields of DHL Global Forwarding, and Nikki Hall of Edge Worldwide Logistics. You've got the envelope, Sam.
And the winner is Christopher Carter.
Chris stepped into the world of freight forwarding at the age of 17 with no previous experience. Joining a small, newly established organization gave Chris the opportunity to receive one-to-one training and be involved in all aspects of the business, an opportunity he embraced and thrived on, working his way through customs and warehousing roles to his current position of Overland and Warehouse Manager and Company Dangerous Goods Safety Advisor. Chris was a finalist in the category back in 2018, and now the winner. Congratulations, Christopher. But that's not all. The judges also want to recognize the achievements of the talented Georgia Gibson of Cargo Partner, whose knowledge of the supply chain and logistics processes has ensured many successes throughout her career. Head to the stage, Georgia, to collect your trophy. Highly commended. Georgia graduated from the University of Huddersfield with a first-class degree in business with supply chain management before taking up the role of global network development with the Cargo Partner in Manchester. It's a tricky way to the stage for you, Georgia, but it's a worthwhile journey. Big round of applause for Georgia Gibson as she heads to the stage.
Fantastic winners there. Love the kilt. Returning to business categories with the two specialist awards. First up, the brand new Sustainable Logistics and the Environment Award, sponsored by American Airlines Cargo. So would Andy Cornwell please join me on stage to announce the winner? Hi, Andy, thank you.
Thanks for joining us, Andy. Now, I can tell you this is brand new for 2023. BIFA and its category sponsor, American Airlines Cargo, are pleased to announce the Sustainable Logistics and the Environment Award. BIFA members are invited to submit their case studies detailing the steps they have taken or are taking to measure and reduce the impact on the environment in any area of their business, whether the activity be independent or in partnership with customers and or suppliers. And so we've got five finalists. Those finalists for Sustainable Logistics and the Environment Award are DHL Global Forwarding. Geodis Freight Forwarding UK. Maersk Logistics and Services UK. Metro Shipping. And Woodland Group. So tell us who the winner is, Andy.
The winner is Woodland Group.
Now that's what I call a celebrating table. The panel was totally impressed with the depth and breadth of the submissions in this new category, showing the industry's commitment to a more sustainable future. The panel was really thrilled to see the long-term commitments Woodland Group has made in this area. They are particularly impressed with the continuous process of monitoring and reducing emissions of every single shipment. Now, as you can imagine, interest was high in the brand new category and the competition extremely tight. Therefore, the sponsor would also like to recognize the submission from Maersk Logistics and Services. Would a representative from Maersk Logistics and Services please make your way to the stage to collect your well-deserved trophy? The panel commented on the pioneering commitment to invest in long-term sustainable solutions throughout the Maersk Logistics and Services business. A highly commended to Maersk Logistics and Services.
Good stuff. Okay, so next up, ladies and gentlemen, is the Extra Mile Award, sponsored by Descartes Systems. Howard Marsh, please join me on stage to make the announcement of this year's winner. Thanks, Howard.
Good to see you, Howard. This category is for members that can provide specific examples of innovation and or customer care by adding value and exceeding their customers' expectations in relation to international shipments by any mode of transport. Perhaps you initiated a joint working group to provide regular feedback or set up a new department or service. The finalists for the Extra Mile Award are Cardinal Global Logistics, Cargo Overseas, Hog Global Logistics, and Cranlee Logistics. Over to you, Howard.
And Descartes are proud to announce that the winner is Hog Global Logistics.
Global Logistics presented a submission that fitted the brief of the award. Taking on the challenge as outlines for consideration of this award was clear winner in going the extra mile. Taking on a prospect many walked away from and providing a very personal solution, which was a great relief to the customer. A real tribute to the small to medium-sized industry players who can offer a successful business model that benefits the customer, the company, and of course, the wider community that they operate in.
Congratulations. Adding a bit of sparkle to the stage there. Just three left now. The modal categories for air, road and sea freight services. And I'd like to invite Daniel Byrne from sponsor IAG Cargo to come up and announce the winner of the Air Cargo Services Award. Thank you.
Good to see you, Daniel. For the Air Cargo Services Award, the judges wanted to hear your case studies involving the movement of goods by air or air sea services and the challenges that you encountered to get the shipment to destination in the new post-pandemic normal. And so, our four finalists for the Air Cargo Services Award are Cargo Partner, Doigro UK, Hogg Global Logistics, and Killick Martin and Company. Over to you, Daniel.
And the winner is Doigro UK Limited.
The judges were particularly impressed by the scale of the move, along with both the technical and geographical complexity that was overcome. Close collaboration was needed to make a project like this happen. And in the judges' opinion, this project entry represented the best side of the cargo industry, achieving fantastic end results for the customer.
Penultimate. The European Logistics Award is next, and I'd like to invite Michael Yarwood from sponsor TT Club to come up and announce the winner of this year's trophy. Thanks, Michael.
Oh my goodness, that was quick. Good to see you, Michael. Now, this category is for freight forwarders using road, short sea, or rail services to provide logistics solutions to and from Europe. With the changes brought about by EU exit, the judges would like to see what your company has done to ensure the continuation of service and customer compliance with new procedures. The five finalists for the European Logistics Award are Atlantic Pacific Global Logistics, Baxter Freight, Brunel European, Espace Europe, and Uniserve Group. Over to you, Michael.
And the winner is Atlantic Pacific Global Logistics.
As our winning team heads to the stage, Atlantic Pacific Global Logistics demonstrated expertise and depth of knowledge to successfully deliver a hugely complex supply chain challenge for a leading retail customer, while also influencing a fundamental change in the customer's logistics model. Congratulations to Atlantic Pacific Global Logistics.
Congratulations. Lovely to have such a popular winner, some great enthusiasm. And now we come to the last, but by no means least, we come to the Ocean Services Award. So please can I call on Adam Dawson of sponsor Port Express to come to the stage to announce the winner. Thanks, Adam.
Great to see you, Adam. Now, forwarders using ocean freight to move cargo around the world have experienced a multitude of problems in recent years, with schedules and equipment availability impacted by many factors and fluctuating freight rates too. If you've used ocean services either as a standalone service or as part of a multimodal shipment, how have you managed customer expectation and mitigated problems? Well, we'll find out. The four finalists for the Ocean Services Award are F.S. McKenzie, Hemisphere Freight Services. Woodland Group. And World Cargo Logistics. Over to you, Adam.
And the winner is Woodland Group.
Well, it's been quite an afternoon from Woodland Group, and we've got people coming up from different parts of the room for this award. Woodland Group successfully delivered a project of 270 containers from Mexico to the UK in a short time frame, while maintaining the client's commitment to carbon efficiency. Woodland Group showed great innovation, expertise, and consistency throughout, showcasing their excellence in ocean freight services. Our winner, Woodland Group. So there it is, everyone, 11 well-deserving winners of the BIFA Freight Service Awards 2023. Please join us in congratulating the winners and all the finalists here today with a big round of applause.